Hey everybody, Jordan's been busy on another project again, and I thought you guys might like a look at it. When we go and film cars, a lot of times my friend Steven Dunsford comes along and he brings along some of his equipment. And one of the things he has is a little Pico dolly, and you actually put a camera on it, and it's got like skateboard type wheels or, you know, skate wheels, and it rolls really smoothly. You can get some nice shots. And the other day when we were shooting a video, I mentioned to Jordan that I'd really like to buy one of those. And he was kind of like, well, why would you buy one when I can build one? So last night he went out to the garage and just scavenged parts like he always does and put something really cool together. And I thought you guys might like it. So we'll go ahead and let him kind of show it to you and tell you what it does and all that kind of stuff.
It's pretty basic design. When Dad told me he wanted one, I figured that it seemed like something I could build pretty easily with just stuff that we had sitting around, because I've seen other people do it and they came out really good, as good as store-bought ones. But I decided to use three wheels because it makes it less tippy, and I made mine a whole lot wider than they normally are because I, you know, don't want it flipping over and breaking one of the cameras. One of the big concerns was we really wanted it to be able to turn, which we kind of thought wasn't going to be doable, but that's where the three-wheel design came in handy too, because this wing nut is on a bolt that's locked into the back, and I can loosen it, and then, well, that falls off. And then you can go like this and make it arc really tight angles around the car, which, I thought that was pretty cool whenever I finally got it to do it right.
And where'd you get the wheels from?
Those are off of old rollerblades, some rollerblades that one of my friends gave me.
So those are nice.
They're bearing wheels.
Yeah, bearing wheels with rubber. That's pretty cool.
We went to Goodwill and bought a tripod. I did this on another piece of camera equipment for him. I just chopped it off so I get the head, and then it'll swivel, and then it'll go up and down. I'm not going to do that because that's not screwed in. We also went by Home Depot and got a, I don't know what this is called.
The quarter inch, would you call it a thumb bolt?
Yeah, I guess. But then this just goes through the bottom and then sticks the cameras through it. I like this head because then no matter what the thread size on whatever camera you have, if you find a bolt, you can still mount any camera to that.
Right.
Which is great because Steve, he's got some Swan cameras and stuff that we just don't really know a lot about. And if he wanted to use this, then he could figure it out. The really cool thing, I mean, it rolls smooth and it turns and stuff, but I really wanted to be able to mount a full-size tripod to it. Because we like the high shots of the motor and stuff, and this is a little big to be setting it on the car.
So we'll show you how he did that. We went to Lowe's and actually picked up these little plastic caps, and he screwed those into the metal there. And as you can see, the front legs of the tripod sit in that.
And then I made this little hook, and the way this works is you actually bend this in and then slide that in, and it pinches the rubber really tight, so then it won't come out.
So then you can actually roll that across the ground. In our case, like when we're filming the cars, we can roll that past the car and get really smooth shots. And with the tripod on there, obviously we can raise that up pretty darn high. So
yeah, it'll go as high as you want it.
Alright guys, I guess that kind of does it, and I think he did a really nice job on it. I was actually really impressed when he first showed it to me, and I still am. So actually, in a lot of our upcoming videos, you're going to be seeing shots made with this particular device, because as you can see, it really works well. I love how it can make those turns, and that's really going to come in handy, like when we're filming around the outside of a car in the showroom. So I think it's going to be pretty cool.
If anybody intends to try to make one, and you have any questions, you can ask, and I'd be happy to answer them and explain how to build it.
Well, anyway guys, I just thought you might find that interesting. Thanks for watching and commenting and everything, and we'll see you later. Bye.